Ladies and gentlemen, once again, welcome back to our channel. And today we are presenting a small presentation on COBOL performance tuning tips. In today's video, we'll talk about 10 simple but important tips that would improve the performance of COBOL program. And thus it will help you in saving the overall application running cost. So before I start with today's presentation, I would request you all to do subscribe to our channel because we need your support to grow our channel. Okay, so let's begin with our today's presentation. I have actually divided this presentation into two sections. First one is planning, other one is coding. So let's start with planning. So first and foremost thing that you need to understand is the application running cost is directly impacted by the system design and the business logic which is written in your COBOL program. A badly designed or non-optimized system will consume more mainframe MIPs as compared to the optimized legacy applications. In order to reduce the cost, it is always recommended that you should look into all the minute details during the design phase. So let's start with our first tip. Tip number one, don't jump to write code. Being a programmer or a designer, it is always recommended that you should spend some time in understanding the requirement. Precisely, prepare a list of functions that you would be planning to use in your program. Next important point is that you need to decide whether you need a single program or you need a multiple program in order to accomplish your requirement. Apart from that, in case if you have a common piece of logic which is used across multiple programs, then it is recommended to include that common piece of logic in a COBOL copybook or maybe in a subprogram to avoid duplication of code. And eventually it will improve the code maintainability and overall application performance. Now let's move on to tip number two, which is estimate the volume of records. In order to optimize the COBOL program, it is always recommended that you should estimate the number of records that your COBOL program is expected to handle. Based on estimates, you can easily predict the number of input-output operations that your program is expected to perform. And based on these estimates and other relevant details, you can decide which is a suitable medium to store the data. That is, it could be a flat file, VSAM cluster, or a DB2 table. But remember, the scope is limited due to the project requirement. Now, let's move on to tip number three, that is prepare structure chart. So by now you have already understood the requirement. You have estimated the number of records. You have taken a decision on storage medium. You have decided the number of programs that you need to accomplish your requirement. So what next? So before writing the actual piece of code, it is always recommended that you should create a structure chart by using a top-down approach. And this is a critical step in the development process. And remember, if you don't do it right, it will have a negative impact on the program performance. You should clearly call out what are the subroutines that you will be using in that program and how exactly control will flow from one para to other paragraph. So what I've done is I've just created a small structure chart. So here is a sample structure chart for a program that will going to generate a report for all the transactions that have failed during the batch process. So what I've done is I've just divided the entire program into 5 different logical sections, and each section is performing a specific function. And you can clearly make out from this particular structure chart that how exactly control is flowing and what are the different functions. So in the similar fashion, it is always recommended that you should prepare a structure chart before actually writing the piece of code. Now let's move on to tip number four, that is careful selection of variables. So the first point in this section is that you should be careful while selecting working storage variables and their data type. Always ensure that you use S in the picture clause for numeric fields. Point number two, you should always use odd number of digits for COM3 variables. Never use even numbers. Point number three, you should use comp for temporary variables, which is predominantly used for calculation purpose. Point number four, avoid unnecessary movement of data from one variable to other variable. I've seen a lot of programs where programmers are actually moving the entire record to working storage variable for certain calculation and then again moving back to the file record. I think it is wastage of resources. So you should only move those fields which is actually required for calculation. Now let's move on to tip number five, that is effective maintenance. And this tip is related to any change that you need to implement in existing program which is already running in production. So whenever you have such requirement, so you need to decide whether program modification should be done within the existing module or if it is better to create one or more new paragraph for your changes. And it is always recommended that you should isolate the change that you are doing in the existing logic and properly tag those changes with all your comments and your change log, so that you can easily identify who has done those changes and what are the project which is related, these changes are related to. Ladies and gentlemen, now let's move on to part two of this presentation. And till now, if you have any questions or comments, then please do write them in the comment section and I'm going to respond back after this presentation. So this section primarily focuses on COBOL coding standards and guidelines. So every organization has a set of rules and guidelines that all programmers should follow while writing their COBOL code. And being a programmer, you should follow these guidelines because it will improve your productivity, the quality of program, and overall performance of an application. So now let's look into all these tips one by one. So let's start with tip number 6, that is evaluate versus if-else statement. So first and foremost thing that I want to highlight over here is that you should always consider using evaluate in case if you have nested ifs. And it is always recommended that you should not use if-else statement for more than 3 nested levels, because the execution of if-else statement consumes a lot of CPU and thus it would lead to extra cost on you. And last point that I want to highlight here is that in case if you're using if-else statement, that always make sure that your if and else and end if are aligned properly. So next point is related to the usage of compound condition. And as I've already mentioned that whenever you're using if-else statement or evaluate statements, always make sure that they are properly aligned. And whenever you're using logical operators, for example, and or not to combine two or more conditions, then you should always use parentheses to avoid any further confusion. Now let's move on to tip number 7, which is COBOL sort versus JCL sort. You should always try to avoid COBOL internal sort or COBOL merge statement in your COBOL program until it is absolutely required. You should always consider using JCL sort utility to sort or merge data into a desired order before it is actually feed into the program for further processing. So this will definitely going to save cost if you compare that with COBOL sort statement or internal merge statement that you normally use in your program. Okay, so now let's move on to tip number 8, that is search versus search all. The performance of search and search all depend primarily on the volume of data. So if you're expecting a low volume of data, that is 50 to 100 odd records, then you should go for serial search. And in case if you're expecting high volume of data, for example, maybe 1000 records, 2000 or 5000 records, then you should always go for search all, that is a binary search. So binary search to search a 1000 element table was 500 times faster than a sequential search, that is search. So finally, based on the data or the number of records that you're expecting in a table, you should take a call whether you should go for serial search or binary search. And I'm sure like if you have taken a correct decision, then definitely you will be able to save a good amount of cost in that. Now let's move on to tip number 9, that is COBOL compiler option. To improve the performance of COBOL application, COBOL compiler option is another important factor that you should always keep in your mind. There are many compiler options, for example, Dynam, NumProc, Optimize, Rent, SSRange, Test, and Truncate that can affect runtime performance. For example, SSRange compiler option can degrade the performance of your program because of an overhead to check the subscript or index item that you've used to access element from the table. So now let's move on to last tip, that is tip number 10, and that is related to COBOL initialize verb. In regards to COBOL initialize verb, I would like to highlight 3 important points. The first one is whenever you are using initialize verb to initialize your copybook or working story, always try to do it in the beginning of the program. Don't try to use this verb again and again in the middle of the program, or don't use this to initialize your working storage variables, right? That is first thing. And second thing is that you should always prefer COBOL value clause to initialize your working storage variable. Apart from that, in case if you are required to reinitialize the copybook again and again, then probably what you can do is you can create a copy of it and initialize it for the first time in your program. and use this initialized copybook to reinitialize the existing copybook which was already having some data. So you can use COBOL move statement, which is far better than initialize verb. Last point is that you should never use initialize statement to initialize big table structure or record descriptions. Now let's look at the last point, which is related to COBOL DB2 and COBOL IMS program. For COBOL DB2 program, you should always commit records to the database as per organization or the project standards. And you should always commit data on a regular interval, right? On a similar term, for a COBOL IMS program, you should release buffer on regular interval to avoid buffer overflow. Last but not the least, I would request you all to follow the tips that we have already mentioned in our previous slides, along with what is being already highlighted or laid down by your organization or the project. And I'm sure that if you follow these guidelines, it will definitely going to improve your productivity, your program quality, and it will thus help you in saving application running cost, because mainframe is all about cost. Ladies and gentlemen, this marks an end to our today's presentation on COBOL performance tuning tips. And in case if you have any feedback or suggestion, then please do write that in the comment section. We will incorporate that in our next presentation on IMS performance tuning, DB2 performance tuning. And last but not the least, I would request you all to subscribe to our channel so that you can get latest notification regarding our new upcoming videos on IMS, DB2 and COBOL. And do check out our video on Kicks COBOL on our channel. Once again, thank you so much, and please do subscribe to our channel, because we need your support to grow our channel. Stay safe, bye-bye, and take care.